Your taxi's arrived, Miss Jennings.
Thank you.
Krystle, where are you going?
I guess you thought that was a pretty cute thing to do. I don't understand.
Hasn't been a perfect day, my dear. I've been run out of one country on a ridgepole. My daughter thinks she's a born-again Lady Godiva, so please forgive me. Now, just what thing did you have in mind?
Setting it up for Matthew Blaisdell and me to run into each other like that in your office.
Oh, that...
What was it, Blake? Some sort of test?
Krystle, I don't suppose you'd believe me if I told you I didn't arrange that. It was just a coincidence.
Was it also a coincidence that you didn't bother to tell me he was back in town? What did you suppose, that I'd go flying off with him? Is that what you think of me?
Come inside. We'll talk.
No. No, you talk too well, Blake. You'd only convince me that I imagined the whole thing, that nothing's changed and everything's exactly the way it was.
Well, isn't it? When will I see you?
I don't know. I've got to get away somewhere where I can think.
Well, at least you can take your own car. Now, this is a very impressive gesture, but you don't have to go by public transportation, you know.
It's not my car. Look at the registration. It belongs to Denver Carrington, just like everything else around here.